This is a top fuel dragster, and everything about this vehicle is designed for maximum acceleration. From its triangular shape, to its specially formulated racing slicks, to its 8,000 horsepower engine. It's all to help this dragster hit 60 miles per hour in just 8/10 of a second. But when it comes to production cars, automakers are still racing to be the first to achieve a sub-2-second 0-60. So why is it seemingly impossible for a production car to go from 0-60 in under 2 seconds? Back in 2016, engineer and YouTuber Jason Finsky tried to find the shortest possible 0-60 time in a production car. Based on current technology, he calculated it would be 2.05 seconds. So how did he get there? For acceleration, maximizing grip is more important than increasing power. All the power in the world is useless if it isn't being applied to the pavement correctly. You need to have the maximum amount of traction possible. But just like a car needs as much traction as possible to take off, it also needs it to stop. To illustrate how quick a car can decelerate, automakers use the distance it takes a car to brake from 60 to 0 miles per hour. Since they both require maximum traction, you can use the formula for braking distance to determine a car's best 0-60 time. For his calculations, Jason used the current record for shortest braking distance, which is 90 feet. Plugging that into the formula for braking distance, along with 60 miles per hour or 88 feet per second for initial velocity, you get an acceleration of 43 feet per second. When you plug that into the formula for velocity and solve for time, you get 2.05 seconds. That means that according to the laws of physics, the limit for 0-60 miles per hour in a production car is right around 2 seconds. The biggest reason for this limit is street tire technology. Race cars and dragsters use completely smooth tires with low air pressure for a reason. This gives the rubber as much contact with the pavement as possible, increasing grip. Street tires have to sacrifice grip in order to be safe for public roads. They feature grooves that reduce the amount of rubber in contact with the ground. These grooves are needed for wet roads because they provide a channel for water to escape. Regular tires also need more air pressure, which also reduces grip, but is necessary for uneven pavement and bumps. And unlike soft and sticky Formula One tires, which need to be replaced after 50 miles, regular tires use a hard rubber compound that's less grippy, but can last up to 90,000 miles. But tire technology continues to break boundaries. Much of this has to do with tire companies and automakers developing cars together. In 2018, the Dodge Demon became the first production car to release with street-legal drag radials. Well, barely street-legal. Dodge warned buyers not to use them in wet weather or on highways. But on the racetrack, they allowed the Demon to reach 0-60 in just 2.3 seconds, the same time as a Model S. This trend of automakers and tire manufacturers developing technology together has continued. Recent examples include Pirelli and Porsche's Taycan, along with Michelin and Bugatti's Chiron. It could be exactly what's needed to raise the bar for how much grip production tires can achieve. Beside road tire technology, drivetrains place a limit on acceleration. Gas-powered cars waste time with the number of moving parts it takes to get usable energy from a single engine. Fortunately, electric cars open new doors in this area, with motors that can send torque to wheels instantly. In an EV like the Model S, which features a motor for each axle, electric torque vectoring can control how much power the front and rear wheels receive. A supercomputer inside the car uses sensors that monitor the vehicle's behavior. This helps it determine how to distribute torque between the wheels for maximum traction. And this can be changed hundreds of times every second. But a new wave of performance EVs may be the answer to hitting the sub-2-second benchmark. The drivetrains feature up to 4 different high-powered motors, one at each wheel. The ability to control each individual wheel makes this distribution of power even faster and could be the key to improving grip on production cars. But even with the grippiest tires possible and the most advanced electric drivetrain, perfect road conditions are the final element to going quick. Unless you've got clear skies, a perfectly flat drag strip, and a sticky surface designed just for racing, you'll never actually know what your car is capable of.